Hey everyone, Hedge here. Today we're going to be building a quarter-sized Wi-Fi pen test tool using the Ghost ESP firmware. This build is incredibly affordable, and for less than $20 you can make 5 of them. For the hardware, we're going to be using the ESP32C3 Mini. There's a bunch of other boards that work too, and I'll link the GitHub in the description so you can go see what boards work. As always, all the links to the parts, software, and resources will be in the description below. Let's get started. I know I wanted a case, so I started sketching the device dimensions in Fusion, and then I started to design the case around it. I don't know why, but I decided to make it look a little bit more rugged. And when I think of rugged, I think of the Galaxy S4 Active. I don't know if you remember these like squared off corners, but I thought they looked kind of cool, and so I thought I would add that to this device. And to top it off, my buddy at Ghosty Mods has this logo that just so happened to work perfectly for this device, the Ghost ESP. Asked him if I could use it, and he was totally cool to let me use it. So you guys get to use it too. I threw the model into Bamboo Slicer and gave it a nice white logo with a black case and sent it over to the printer. I think it came out pretty nice. I uploaded it to MakerWorld with and without the multi-material logo. And if you don't have a printer, don't worry. The sponsor of this video is PCBWay. I've used them a few times now with PCB manufacturing. You might have seen my PCB in the Marauder video, but they also have 3D print services. So if you want to get this case made in a nice PETG or even like a nylon, you can get it from them. Huge thank you to our sponsor PCBWay for helping making these videos happen. So before we put it in the case, we'll need to flash the firmware. To do that, you'll need to place your ESP32 in bootloader mode. To do that, hold down the boot button while plugging it into your computer. If done right, your computer should recognize the device. Now let's move over to the computer. First, open Google Chrome and head to the GitHub page for the Ghost ESP firmware. Link will be in the description. Find the flashing guide. Don't worry, it's really straightforward. Find the link to the flashing guide and click it. Once here, we'll find the link to the online web flasher. You'll want to go to this website. Once here, we'll hit the drop-down for select your board, and we'll want to choose the ESP32C3. And then for the custom board drop-down, you'll hit generic. After that, click flash, and then you'll be prompted to select a device. Your device should show up here if it's in bootloader mode. If you don't know which COM port, restart the process, and you'll see it pop up in that window. And that's it, the hard part's over. We'll just give it some time to flash now. Now that that's done, let's go ahead and head over to spookytools.com and we'll go ahead and try to connect to the device. Click the Serial Console tab and then click Connect. Then you'll just choose the same device that you were using before. And if you just flashed it, you may need to restart the device. Let's check out a couple of the commands that you can run. So I'll run the help command. I think I'll demonstrate how to perform a deauth attack. So to do that, we'll actually need to use scanap. Once you find that, it'll give you a list of SSIDs and a number associated with the Wi-Fi, and that'll be the number that you use in the deauthentication attack. And instead of performing the attack on the website serial console, I'm going to go ahead and switch over to PuTTY. I actually prefer to use my own terminal clients, and I kind of recommend you do the same. So the command I used here is attack-d, and then the number of the Wi-Fi that I want to attack, which was 0. And that's it, it takes down the 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi. Now that everything's working, I'm going to go ahead and throw it into the case that we made. Here's a little bonus footage of me using it with my Hackberry Pi. It's a CyberDeck made by Zitao Tech. And they're really hard to get your hands on, but if you can, it's insanely worth it. It's so much fun. And that's the build. There's plenty more tools to use in the web UI and especially with commands. But after using it for a few days, I found that the web UI was lacking in most of the tools. And this is great if you want something really cheap to play around with. But if I had to recommend Ghost DSP, I would definitely use the cheap yellow display and flash that. If you've watched my Marauder build video, you can basically do the exact same thing, but replace the flashing steps with going to that spooky tools web flasher and choose ESP32 room. And then you would end up with something that looks like this. The one thing I like about this build is that almost all the features are available through the UI. Like, you don't have to console into the device, which makes it a lot more usable. So if you prefer this build, it's quite a bit more expensive, but still under $20, but you can only make one. You just buy this display. And then the case and everything is in the description of that video. But I'll go ahead and throw up a card or something now to that tutorial. But that wraps it up for this one. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I just got a new camera, and I'm curious to see if any of my returning viewers have noticed a quality of improvement. I've also been working on my video editing and just trying to make better videos in general. So I've been looking at the comments and taking your guys' critique, and I appreciate it. So thanks, everyone.